Lord Jesus, wonderful Savior, there is none like you this morning. And even in this little devotion, O God, Father, we realize that how important your presence is. We cannot even speak for these few moments without you being with us. Father, there are many young people out there that are in need, that are in trouble. Some of them, Lord, is in a backslidden condition. Some of them, O God, has a complex because of their position. Some of them, God, is depressed because they don't know which way to go. And also, they have been caught up in the challenges of this life. A gracious Father, we come before you and we open up your word and we realize that how important you are this morning to us and to all the young people, young and old. We want to pray this morning for the presence of the Almighty God to drop down upon thy word and to bless the word. And when this little devotion will be sent out to many young people and believers out there, we pray, O God, that you would bless it and that you will inspire it and that you will anoint it in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Be completely blessed this morning, young people, wherever you are this morning. I really trust the Lord that you are taking some time just to settle down a little bit. It's also a holiday, amen, so you are at home for this week, and that is why we are talking to you a bit this week. So while mommy, amen, is preparing for work, you can quickly grab her phone and you can listen to the little devotion. And if you have your own number, amen, let us send it also to you, your phone, so that you can also have your time of listening to this little devotion. It is important, young people, like we said, that your position and you are very important in the kingdom of God. You are very, very important. I don't care this morning what people think about you and what people say about you. But what I want to say is, the servant of God, you as a young boy, young girl, you are very important for the economy of the Almighty God. You are very important. And God wants to use you like you have never seen before. Maybe you underestimate the ability that God has placed within you. But let no man, amen, hallelujah, let no man despise your youth. And very important, lead by example. Lead by example, young boy, young girl, lead by example. You set the example. You set the pace. Amen, hallelujah. Set the example for other young people and let them see, amen, what God has placed within you. Educated, uneducated, rich or poor, lead by example. Don't underestimate the power of God in your life, young sister and young brother. Genesis 37, let's read from verse 1. We will try to finish this little brother in the next few moments. This brother has a rich, rich, amen, experience. And I believe that the young people can also learn from the life of Joseph. Genesis chapter 37, let's read from verse 1. And Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph being 17 years old. Wow. Yes, Brother Nicky. There was young people in the Bible. Joseph being 17 years in the years old was feeding the flocks with his brethren, and the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons, praise the name of thy father's house, till Shelah, my son, be grown. For he said, let's peradventure he die also as his brethren did. And Tamar went and dwelt in her father's house. Amen. And then you can read, very important, young people, you have a lot of time this morning. Read the whole Genesis 37. You will quickly pick up, amen, the life and how Joseph, amen, hallelujah, was used by God. We will just pick up here and there a few things. Joseph was a favorite of his father. Remember that his father made him a coat. Amen. He was a favorite of his father. God gave Joseph favor and wisdom in the sight of Pharaoh. Amen. And Joseph, amen, also had challenges. The challenges that Joseph faced during the course of his duties. Remember, when you read, you will also pick up that Joseph's brothers, amen, was not happy because of the favor that rested upon Joseph. And that is where we want to underline a little bit and spend one or two more minutes on the favor of God, amen, upon Joseph. And sometimes you don't even realize, young sister, young brother, that the favor of God is resting upon you. And there are some people out there, there might be someone out there in the college, at your workplace, amen, is jealous, amen, because of the favor of God, amen, that is resting, upon you. Hallelujah. That is resting upon you. Amen. The favor of God that is resting upon you. And what we read in the Bible, amen, hallelujah, that these brothers, the brothers of Joseph, amen, hallelujah, they sold him, amen, hallelujah, to strangers that were passing by. The Median merchandisers, merchant men, amen, verse 28, amen, they took Joseph, threw him in a pit. And when these merchant men passed by, amen, they drew and lift up Joseph out of the pit and sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of silver, and they bought Joseph into Egypt. But the story of Joseph is so rich, it's so important. And Joseph ended up in the house of Potiphar. My, working as a servant boy in the house of Potiphar. The whole story of Joseph is so rich. To see how God was able to use Joseph. And during the course of his duties, Potiphar's wife cast longing eyes towards Joseph. She attempts to seduce him, but he resists that. She attempted, amen, hallelujah, to influence Joseph. And how many times did you got to a place where somebody wanted to seduce you, or what we can also say, that want to influence you, amen, to do something that you don't want to do? Praise the name of the Lord. And this is what we are dealing with this morning, is for us to realize, young people, that we should know our stand, amen, for the gospel. Smit weet waar ons staan in die evangelie van die Here Jesus Christus. Amen, hallelujah. Potiphar's wife, amen, hallelujah, She wanted to seduce, she wanted to influence this young little boy, 17 years old. How can I do this great? And she attempted to seduce him, but he with firm resolve, amen, resisted, insisting, how can I do this great weakness and sin against God? Oh my, isn't that wonderful? I want to repeat that. How can I do this great weakness and this sin against God? Genesis 39, amen, verse 9, amen. You can also just open your Bibles and read as follows. Amen. That Joseph, his question to her was, what is your question to the influences of the world today? What is your question, amen, to the influences of this world? When Satan comes like a flood and he wants to destroy your life and he wants to break you into pieces and seduce you and take you away from the principles of the word, what is your answer or what is your question this morning to the influences of this world? And very important, amen, you can read also Genesis 39 verse 7 to 10. A young boy in a strange land, oh my, outside his comfort zone. Young people, I hope you understand. I hope you are listening in this morning. Out of his comfort zone, away from his family, away from his father, away from his mother, away from his brothers, away from, oh my, the normal ins and outs. Remember, Joseph in a strange land, young people, away from his people. Amen. We can even say, you young people in the colleges, you young people, hallelujah, at school, you young people, amen, that stays with your uncle or with your grandparents, amen, away in a strange land, separated from his people and his church, but yet so faithful to his God, separated from his people. So young people, you have no excuse whatsoever. Amen. Jy het nie 'n verskoning vanoggend nie om afvallig te word en jou rug te draai teen die woord. Amen. There was a young man. You have no excuse, amen, to get into the world and to run around with the things of the world because you are not close to a church. You are not close to the believers. You are not close to your family. Amen. Hallelujah. Here we are dealing with a 17-year-old boy. I'm saying this while the sun is rising and the sun is shining on my face this morning. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Though this young man was being separated from his family, amen, they took him to a strange country. But yet, amen, so faithful to the cause of the gospel. Amen. Remember, young people, as the story unfolds, we learn that Joseph was being used by Jehovah as a profound, amen, instrument for the preservation of the Hebrew nation. Joseph, you can read the verses of Genesis, hallelujah, 39, and you can continue by reading, and you will see how this little story unfolds and how God used Joseph, and how this little story unfolds and how, amen, instrumental Joseph's life was. Don't underestimate the teaching of your mother in the house, young girl, in the name of Jesus, young boy. Don't underestimate your father's teaching in the house. Don't take it for granted, hallelujah, because one of these days You're going to need that teaching when you go to university, when you go to school, when you go to a strange country, when you go away, away from your family, and there's no family around you. Don't take the teaching of a godly mother and a godly father for granted, because God has something in store for you when you leave the house. Maybe you will not be leaving the house like the way Joseph, amen, was dropped into a pit. Amen, hallelujah, been sold to this merchant man. Hallelujah, been taken to a far country. Hallelujah, amen, the Ishmaelites, amen, selling him for 20 pieces of silver. No, maybe you are not leaving the house like that, but what is important as we close, when we pray, hallelujah, because the time is up already, hallelujah, remember, don't take the teaching of a godly father and mother for granted, because one of these days you're gonna need this teaching. Hallelujah, you're gonna need the support. You're gonna be standing on your own. You're gonna be standing alone. Hallelujah, and you have to stand for what you have been taught. Hallelujah, and this is what we experience in this little story, hallelujah, that something unfolded, the life that unfolded, and how instrumental Joseph was, amen, in God preserving his life. God took him through all these challenges. Don't run away from the challenges. Allow God to take you through all these challenges. He will keep you. The teaching will keep you. Amen. Those godly mothers and fathers that taught you the principles of the word and who Jehovah was, those teachings is important when you go through all these challenges, young people. Father, bless our young people this morning. Bless your word, O God, as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.